You had plenty of clearance coming out, so you're good there, but I don't know how it feels.
That feels good to me.
Feels all right?
Yeah.
That's the main thing. And you're plenty clear coming out, so 20 in.
20 in?
20 in.
Okay. Okay.
That's good.
17?
17.
I just go right down the rest that way. Deadlift socks. You go all the way up to your knee. Okay. Cigarette. T-shirt.
Rack heights and stuff are on the back wall. You need those before you check in.
Underwear.
What? Rack heights and stuff.
Okay. Elbow sleeve.
No elbow sleeve.
Knee wrap.
I used to do sleeves.
Sleeve. Wrist wrap. Okay. Headband.
Headband?
Headband, yeah. You were. Don't want to keep them curls in place. All right, man.
All set?
Yeah. Go ahead and read this. Are you sure?
Good lighting right on top.
Good.
You want to slip on?
Go into everything.
You're at 124.0.
What's that putting in?
You need to gain another 2.5 pounds.
So that's 270.
Drink some water.
273?
Did you want the 140 plus?
Right.
Okay, so you got to get above, you have to go 125.1.
Okay. Okay, no problem.
So you got about basically 16 ounces of water.
16? Okay. Okay, so I weighed in about 2 pounds under, so I just got to drink like 16 ounces of water, and I'll be good to go to make the 308 class.
Yeah.
Just got to chug a couple bottles of water, no big deal. Much easier gaining than losing.
That's fucking
bulky right there.
119.1. What was it?
Wait, 274 or so? 273. Okay, yeah, I guess I'll shoot everything out.
You can take off those two.
Yeah, you can take off those two. Yeah. But 16 ounces. This would be like a little 3 pounds.
Goodwill.
When you get a waist going, you're fucking acting like you're about to deadlift. You're just fucking
kind of bouncing
all
over. Yeah,
bounce on that shit. Get more water just in case.
I didn't peek inside or anything. You didn't see that.
Today and tomorrow, we're going to finish that whole canister of aminos.
Jesus.
BCAA XL.
My dumb, I'll just be pissed at the same time.
What we're looking for.
125.4. All right.
We're all set.
All right. I got to put my brain down.
Come on, now, let's go.
All right. Jesus Christ. Try to rotate a little bit.
Can't hear you.
Try to rotate it to the left a little bit. Okay. That's good.
A little bit more.
All right.
by lifters and powerlifting fans, we are just under 10 minutes away from day number two of the 2018 Kern U.S. Open.
How you doing?
You're good, man. How you feeling?
We'll see. It was a harder cut than it should have been, but you look good. I'm excited to do what you do.
Same here,
I'm
man.
A little sad to get beat by a guy in sleeves, but I can take it. I can take it. But we're going to see it.
Yes, sir.
All right.
It's not 242 days.
It'll be different.
I like the looks of that from Lane. And judges, they like it too.
Come on.
you know, white lights. Nail this white little lights. Bit, yeah. Right? Let's do it.
That's what it's all about. Beats, today. Right?
Making progress would be, as long as we're a little bit ahead, each lift, that's the most important thing. Okay? Yeah. So let's nail this one. Strength there. That was beautiful. Strength your lap. Walkout was perfect. Same thing on the next one. Okay? Doing great. Competition PR for Larry, so got his third attempt, we're in good position, did a record total. So
Jake Johns calling for 392 and a half kilos. Brandon Stew on deck, David Douglas in the hole. Bowling and Excel. Platform ready, and don't forget, the ultimate title presented exclusively by 8-Man. And a Muhammad's opening attempt, your judges say, good lift. Platform ready right now. A second attempts are underway. 402 pounds and Garrett Fear. Zachary having a real good day so far. He calls for 210 kilos in his second attempt. And Carlos Reyes on deck and Foster Parnell in the hole. Platform ready right now for Zach. 463 pounds, third attempt. And your judges say, not quite there.
That one, that's why it was a little harder. Bring it in, keep that chest proud, okay?
Okay.
you look like you had lift.
You got him.
To the same way you should be a whole thing another ball to yourself.
I have a hold clutch pedal. I saw Dylan do a hold for a second.
Yeah,
I'm a hold to yourself. And don't bring it out as far either. All
right, so Brandon is coming up next.
Hi, Bridget.
All right. You got this. Let's go.
Yes.
You're away. Let's go. Come on.
Big man lifted out of NYC right now. He goes for 6-12 on the bar. Brought to you in part locally by Grid Fitness, RSM Bed, X Beds, and Squat to Death. All right, platform ready right now with 684 pounds. And for Zachary. All right, let's see those dance steps, Zachary. Show me that dance steps. All right, Silva calls.
All right, platform ready for your NYC lifter. 727 pounds and Larry Williams.
Let's go! One and three, let's get it.
Platform ready, ladies and gentlemen, with 838 pounds.
I think that locks up third place. The 592 Wilkes or so. It's the best Wilkes he's had. So great day for Larry Williams.
What the Grim Reaper today? What the Grim Reaper today?
A few things didn't go as planned, but it just an eye opener, and I know the standard that I need to meet for next year, and. Just my training accordingly. Regardless of whatever, last year I bombed on my third attempt squat. I didn't even make it to the bench. So this is a huge progress from last year. I did the biggest power for me in the world. So I'm happy that this judging was strict. That way there's no controversy about, oh, the pull should have been longer, the squat should have been deeper. And, 15-pound meet PR at 275. And, you know, no complaints, not hurt. I have the rest of the year to recover, train, and do even better next year.
And the gold medal, also from 2292, the weight of 125.4 kilo, gold medal to Larry Williams from New York.
Yes, folks! Yes, folks! The third place with a $5,000 payout and a world score of 592.28 goes to Larry Williams in a 1.08 class. The second place with a 600.679 world score and $10,000 goes to Brandon Allen. And first place with a 611.105 world score and $40,000 payout to Yuri Belkin.
What's up, guys? Coach Gaglione here. So with Larry, obviously, I finished up a great day. You saw his list. Just to kind of recap all the lifts of the day, finished with an 821 squat, 589 bench, 881 deadlift, in the kilos, 372.5 kilo squat, 267.5 kilo bench, 400 kilo deadlift, which is a very elite barrier. Both the squat and the deadlift were competition PRs, which is always good. Which at the end of the day, the gym lifts are training, the meet was run very tight to a high standard. The squats were very deep. Benches were paused very long. Obviously, you know, using the smaller plates on the deadlift can be a factor. So all in all, it was a great day. Like I said, the total PR, squat PR, deadlift PR, ended with 1,030 kg total, 2291 total, which is a PR total. And like I said, he weighed in a very light 308, which helped him get a PR Wilk score of 592. And some change. So he weighed in as a light 308 with 275.5 pounds. He actually ended up tying your boy Dennis Cornelius. I guess Larry's got his number, but since he tied him, he won the 308 class by body weight. So that puts an extra dough in your pocket. And then we ended up edging out a couple of guys. There's a lot of great competitors, Andrew Herbert, some other guys that were very close in that kind of upper 500 Wilkes range. Brandon Allen seemed a little bit out of reach. Yuri Belkin seemed a little out of reach. So we decided to kind of play it safe. We go for third. We kind of swung with that 400 kilo deadlift. We kind of knew it was in the wheelhouse. And I think that's probably all you had for this particular day. So how'd that feel kind of picking up that last deadlift?
I never had grinded and deadlift that long. Grip was an issue, but overall it was a 10 pound kilogram deadlift PR. I've hit 900 with the wider plates, and you know, going in.
Not squatting and benching before is a little different, of course. You know?
Exactly. So, more importantly, that was a 30 pound deadlift meet PR?
Yeah, it was about, about 30 pounds deadlift PR in competition, which right. are the ones that count. Like that 400 kilo number is a very elite number, and there's definitely not a lot of guys doing that under 300 pounds. So for someone to do that at wing of just over 275, especially this lean, super rare, super impressive. And like I said, doing it on a big stage in front of a crowd is not easy. So we're very proud of Larry for that. So I know we still got, where are some of like your kind of goals kind of moving forward after this meet? So we kind of wrapped up this competition. We came home with some dough. I know you still want to attack that 308 record. What else is kind of on the horizon for you?
So for the summer, my plans are to work on my PT day motive to restore my movement that's been lost over years of not doing mobility work, not really taking the best care of my body, get healthy, hit deeper squats, you know. I have some back pain I've been fighting for since November, and I never, you know, let it heal all the way, so I've only been able to squat every 2-3 weeks, pull every 3 weeks.
You only have to make some adjustments to the plan.
Exactly. So with that said, by the end of the summer, first of all, throughout the summer, I'm not going to be squatting deadlift. I'll be benching. And
a little more hypertrophy type training, bodybuilding type work, unload the spine a little bit.
Exactly, unload the spine. And from about September to November, I'm going to be prepping for my first national pro bodybuilding show. And the goal there is to just place top 10. And then I would like to give another shot at the 308 record next year in May at the current US Open. So, I know the standard that I need to train to. You know, I wasn't squatting as deep as I needed to in training. I wasn't pausing my benches.
Some of the workouts toward the end.
Right.
I think it's just a matter of also being consistent.
Right.
And sometimes when you get a little excited, things get a little heavier in the training cycle. You start to cut your squats a little short. Start to kind of maybe touch and go some of your benches, or kind of like a soft pause. And that's fine from time to time, but especially as you get close to the meet, you want to train as specific as possible. If you hold yourself to a higher standard in training, it's obviously going to have a higher transfer going into the meet. So thank you guys for watching. Make sure you guys subscribe. Definitely, you know, drop a comment. Show Larry some love. And we'll see you next time on the platform.
See you guys soon. Thank you. Yep. Watch the live stream. Thank you. And I'll just speak to you soon.